This is going to be a very basic introduction and overview to Qabalah. The subject can be rather complex, but I think it is actually pretty easy to get a basic understanding. I'm not a Kabbalistic scholar and have only been studying it since 03, but I think I have a good general grasp on it. I'm going to start out very fundamental because I've met a lot of atheists on here and I don't want to blow their minds too severely. I always liked Eastern religions, especially Taoism and Zen, which are more philosophical systems than religions. As a model and metaphor, not literally, I can see that the universe could be considered the Tao, or way as it translates, the flow of nature, which from a scientific view can be the laws of physics and so on. When Einstein talked about God, he meant it as the laws of science and the mystery and wonders of existence. Everybody knows the general idea, the force, from Star Wars, that everything is interconnected, one vast whole, the Tao, the universe. I always liked that, but it only got me so far. Where do you go from there? And then I came across Qabalah, an esoteric teaching of Judaism. Qabalah is a Hebrew word meaning to receive inner wisdom from mouth to ear, as it's an oral tradition. The Tree of Life diagram is a map or chart of the emanations from the void, nothingness, to somethingness, the physical world. These emanations are thought of as aspects of the universe. To be honest, technically in Qabalah, they usually refer to these emanations as Yahweh, God, the Godhead, the Divine. But my interpretation, which I think is valid, is to look at these qualities of, to look at these as qualities of nature or the universe. Just as the word gay used to be a derogatory term for homosexuals, I think we need to reclaim the word God as a term with a deeper and more resonant meaning. I think some atheists can at least look at these things as concepts, poetic metaphors. Here's the basic diagram with the ultimate source at the top, moving down, still very abstract, archetypal forces or energies, and down to more concrete concepts through the human unconscious, and finally reaching our physical world of matter, here where we all reside, getting to into our various styles of mischief. Now let's start at the very beginning of everything, literally, the whole shebang. That first point or state of nothing from which the universe somehow emerged. I made a quick montage to show what Qabalah calls the three primordial states, and I admit and apologize that my Hebrew pronunciation is far from perfect, but I'm getting better, I hope. They are called Ein, Ein Sof, and Ein Sof Or. These are the singularities, the moments before, during, and at the very beginning. The starting point of the universe, which is also known as the Big Bang. In the science of physics, it's currently theorized that the universe spontaneously came into existence due to quantum fluctuations from a point within the quantum vacuum. Qabalah's metaphorical imagery for this idea could be an example of a higher truth achieved intuitively. It's almost embarrassing, but Qabalah says that these first three stages can't even be described, as they are beyond our conceptual ability. Just as physicists say that right at the moment of the singularity, the Big Bang, the mathematics and laws of quantum physics break down. They simply don't or can't apply here, mainly because this is before time, as we know it, even existed. We could call this an ineffable state. To get a taste or sense of the nuance of this Kabbalistic tree model, let us note that these three prior stages are not even a part of the tree per se. You could say they are pre-tree. Only now have we just reached the very tip-top of the tree. So let's get to the structure of the tree itself, the 10 sephiroth, the 10 archetypal forces. The word sephiroth means emanations or spheres. The singular is sephiroth. These are vessels, and each one represents a particular energy. Okay, yeah, the word energy has a goofy New Age vibe to it, where it's used or misused all over the place. So let's use the terms power or force. They're a bit better. With the visual aid of my Tree of Life poster, let's very briefly take a cursory look at each sephiroth. If I get positive feedback, or maybe even if I don't, I will do a part 2 vid discussing each one in more detail. Obviously, each sephiroth has its own unique properties. There is a very extensive background in history for the meaning, symbolism, and associations for each sphere. And what is very fascinating is how they relate to and balance each other. Okay, now, here's a quick overview of the tree. Think of it as a map of a continent, with each sephiroth as a major city, from Los Angeles to New York. The first one, Keter, means crown, as it sits at the top. This is God, the Godhead, the ultimate source, the first emanation or manifestation, something from nothing. This leads us to number 2, Chokmah, meaning wisdom. This is the first primordial energy, the active male principle or archetype. And directly across from it is number 3, Bina, which means understanding. This is the receptive female archetype or principle, the mother, compassion, mother nature, fertility. Moving diagonally, pass through the abyss. The missing or false sephiroth. Doth means knowledge, a kind of knowledge that's beyond sense. Knowledge knowable only by its absence. Leaving the abyss, we reach number 4, Chesed, or mercy, protection, the father, kingly kindness, the unconditional love of the universe for its children. And directly across is number 5, Gibberah, severity, strength, toughness, stern judgment, cold decisions, the laws of nature, karma. These two forces balance each other. Severity without mercy is cruelty. Mercy without severity is weakness. We move a bit lower to number 6, Tippereth, or beauty, harmony. This represents our central self, the will, the soul, the light of the sun, mythically the guardian angel, the point of balance the other spheres revolve around, mankind's highest point and God's lowest, where the two connect. This is beauty. Einstein said, beauty is truth. And down a bit to number 7, Nitzach, victory. Feelings, emotions, and best of all, love. Venus and Aphrodite, that first attraction. Do we have emotions or do emotions have us? Directly across is number 8, Hod, splendor. Hod represents thought, the mind, science, language, intellect, and magic, symbols and communication. Here again are two balancing forces, thoughts and feelings. Moving lower and closer to the physical realm to number 9, Yesod, or the foundation. The place of dreams, the unconscious, the moon, lunacy, the realm of fantasy, the creativity of dreams, imagination, leading directly down to number 10, Malkuth, kingdom, the physical plane on which we reside, the world of matter, the earth. That's Qabalah in a nutshell. The Tree of Life is a model of the structure of the universe and also of each individual human soul, psyche, or essence. Mysticism teaches as above, so below. The individual and the universe are reflections of each other.